Hello everyone, welcome back to another video. We're back at Adelaide Central Railway Station, Platform 4. There's a 3000 class here today. This will be my first time ever taking a 3000 class train. It's basically the same as the other train, the other diesel train, the 3100 class. The only notable difference is that it doesn't have walk-through carriages because there's a cab on both ends. So here you have 3019. So literally it's a one-car train. It's just one-car sets with a cab on both ends. They do connect them like this through the cab, but you can't walk through there. So they are disconnected. It's basically two one-car sets together to make a two-car set, which is so crazy. In Perth, two-car is the smallest thing, and you can connect two, three cars together to make a six-car set, which would be crazy in this situation. We're gonna get on board. This is service to Belair, departing at 11:46, which is still 9 minutes away, but the trains wait here for like 20, 30 minutes sometimes at the central station, but they actually, the doors close before it departs, it always closes. So you can see it's just a one car train, and I got the whole train to myself, and the driver's cab is in there, so you can't go in there, so we have the whole one car train to ourselves. And now let's take a look at the map today. This is the second last line we have to cover. I've covered the Outer Harbour, Grange, Flinders and Seaford lines. Today we'll be taking the Belair line, which travels three stops along the Seaford and Flinders, and then travels up a very steep hill with lots of curves to get to Belair, the terminus at the top of the hill. It's like a very curvy line, and it'll be very cool to have these one-car diesel trains going up the line. So yeah, we're just gonna do that. And even though it looks so short, it's actually, is it that, no, Flinders is and Grange, the spur lines, which are shorter, but it's the longest, I mean the shortest singular line with no spurs. It still takes over 45 minutes to arrive at the terminus, which is so long, because the diesel train up the hill is probably like 20 kilometers an hour, to be honest.
This is a train service to Belair. The next stop is Mile End. arriving at Torrens Park. Please mind the gap. arriving at Blackwood. Alight here for local bus services.
Still. And ready? Let's see.
next stop is Belair. This train will terminate here.
Belair train station. This train has arrived at its terminus at the here we are all the way at the top of the hill. There's some trains in storage over there, a small depot. You can see those diesel trains over there. There's two platforms here. Let's go across the freight line now. Here we are. This is the station. There's an information sign here. And there's a train. It's crazy how it goes up this steep hill. You can see the toilets here. And then as soon as you exit the station, it's just a gravel path and you're right next to the Belair National Park. Right there you can enter, which is very cool how accessible it is here. There's not really any other lines like this in Australia, going a suburban rail line up a hill. The elevation of Belair is about 300 meters, which is more than Kalamunda in Perth. So imagine building a train line, like imagine extending the airport line to Kalamunda up the hill. But with a diesel train, because electric and up the hill would be so weird. Yeah, it would be just crazy, wouldn't it? Yeah, so here we are. There's a school up there as well, and they get a great view down of the train, St. John's Grammar. And we have arrived. We're just watch the train depart as soon as it does. We've got asphalt platforms. Such a unique station. Three tracks. I'm not sure if this other platform is used. Probably not, because it's on the freight standard gauge, I think. And the depot seems to be over there, and they never would need more than two trains here. We'll just wait for it to depart now. Never mind, it departs in 13 minutes. It has a very long layover. So we'll end the video here with the view of sets 20 and 19 at Belair Station, the terminus of the line, the green one, all the way up the hill. And we're going to exit now and we'll take a look around here. Yeah, there's quite a few trains parked over there. About 6 or 7 diesel trains in that little depot. Thanks for watching and bye. Viewed in the middle of the bush above a tunnel on the Belair Line. The left track, a train's gonna come rumbling out of the tunnel right now and we're gonna see it pass us here. You'll probably hear it any second rumbling through the tunnel. I don't know what this is, just some barbed wire. It's all closed off, but it's gonna come very shortly. Shh. I can hear a tiny bit of wind through the tunnel. Set 14 and I didn't see the front one passing through. It actually honks here, so maybe like it's meant for people to cross here because it honks, whistles in case someone is crossing. Anyway, it passed now. Let's go back through this treachery path. Holy crap, I'm gonna put my phone away to get back. It's a very bad path, you don't want to be here. Oh dear. In the middle of a national park, a Belair Line train is coming through. Right next to the train tracks here. Absolutely no fence around. You can just be right next to the line.